We are very clued in. This project has been completely rehearsed. We know exactly what we're doing. Everybody understand that? If they go spectacularly wrong and we need to evacuate immediately, leave everything behind. Do not take your purses. Take off your high-heeled shoes. There is a flotation device under your seat. Do not inflate that before you leave the room. Exits in the back, out there, and remind you over there. Please don't trip over anybody or anything on your way out the door because we will be out first. Fine. So, let me present to you the unforgettable, the absolutely spectacular and totally planned Christmas lecture. Gentlemen.
Why are we all here? Well, every time I say, why are we all here, people say, because it's, the weather's better than it is in England. So I thought I would recycle this slide from last time, which was 2 years ago, so only a few of you will remember it. It's to prove that in Mansfield, in Nottinghamshire, it rains less than it does here. Because it's quite difficult to adjust to Germany. You have to remember to put your house shoes on, your slippers on. Because otherwise you get told off, I find. Or no, you don't. People are insistent that you're going to get ill. Even though you say, I've been running an experiment my entire life, never wearing them, and it hasn't actually affected me yet. Because the idea that I had today was that we would try to make a mushroom cloud. Not obviously the one that's made of water, because that's quite difficult. And not really one made out of plutonium. That's probably not very good for our life expectancies.
I want my money back!
Okay, is there anybody here that is colorblind?
I'm alright.
So if you have a party and you want to have a nice cocktail, this is a recipe for you. First, I'm gonna put it in. Yeah. Don't worry, I'm a professional.
Don't worry,
So we have there a liquid that we thought was green, but no, turns out it's red.
So and oh,
dodged. Is it gonna turn yellow now?
It does if you drink it.
Really?
It takes about 4 hours.
The colors of the juice is depending on how thick your container is. Two metal tubes. One is made from aluminium. The other is, yes. That's a good idea.
What's the story? So we're going to have two tubes of more or less the same length. And we are going to very carefully, because we have the high-tech video camera system going here, and we have these things perfectly aligned. No biasing. All right, so what we got is a race. Now, we have a heavy-duty magnet. Everybody knows here, right? Because you've all done physics. Wow.
They've all failed.
They've all fit. Everybody failed physics?
You all tried physics.
They tried physics once and decided it was a bad idea. I did that too. I got a whole degree in it. It took me a lot longer to understand. Okay, so we have two tubes. One of them is copper. Copper. Magnetic?
I hope it didn't come from my house.
Really? Okay, so we got one person that failed physics. Copper is not particularly magnetic. We have another one. Aluminum. Aluminium. Aluminum? Aluminium? Doesn't really matter. Is it magnetic?
No.
No.
Therefore, there should be no effect whatsoever of the pipe on our two magnets, correct? Everybody agree with this? What do you mean, no? He said, yeah. Out. Okay, so, we're taking bets.
Don't ruin the magic.
Yeah? Taking bets? Are they going to arrive on the ground, as Newton predicts, at the same time?
No.
Okay, let's try that one more time. A resounding no or a yes. Are they going to arrive on the ground at the same time? Let me hear you say
no.
That's a no.
Okay. They're too smart. Go for it.
Why not? Don't you guys believe in gravity?
That's a good question. They don't believe in gravity. They've seen the movie. They know that it doesn't work. All right, go for it.
It's because it's short.
Physics.
Okay.
Are you ready? On your mark.
The bet.
Get set. Bang! Anytime, y'all.
He was closer to the ground.
Slow magnets are good. Yeah. Slow magnets are slower than fast magnets. That's what makes them good.
Since at some point, I mean, the fun is over, we have to return to the actual topic of our lecture, which was?
Christmas.
Christmas. The real topic, come on. And so he created the Harrisburg. Right? And the Harrisburger is just a hamburger which has mushrooms on it, mushroom clumps. And it's sort of radioactive. I had to taste it once, and it also tastes radioactive, actually. But so what happens, basically, the gas is drawn downwards, and then there's still air coming up, and that's what the mushroom cloud does. So you see here the picture of the arrows depicting this process. Okay, I think I would like to spend the next 2 or 3 hours just introducing you to the basic fluid dynamics.
Don't drink the chemicals.
Oh, too late.
Okay, so this is a donut event.
I'd like him to have his hands free.
You know how much the cloud is going to be.
This is a tool for making these rings of air, which are just like a mushroom cloud. How disappointed you are to see the completeness of this experiment. But it's quite good because Anna can take this thing here and shoot you in the face with it. Not me, because I'm not entirely sure that nothing will come from shooting out. But I thought I would make it a little bit more interesting by putting some smoke in there. It turns out when you make these things, when you learn how to make these things, you're not in a very good state to remember how to do it later, so it might not work very well. So maybe I won't do that. Also, there's a law about it, I think. So maybe we won't do that one. Oh, I forgot which end was which again. One of these ends tastes horrible, and the other one doesn't. So what I'm going to do is put a little bit of smoke in here.
I'm not supposed to do that.
Now, you probably don't want a face full of boiling water. Probably not. Let's see if I can shoot somebody with it. That was underwhelming. We'll have to make a bigger one.
The very definition of underwhelming.
Well, so let's practice this. It's a really good build-up. Yeah. You guys were all terrified. In fact, so terrified that the camera
they were
just actually even blinked.
Let's try again.
These sorts of things are good. Oh.
Yes.
Well, we're getting there.
So that's a little bit disappointing. So what I was thinking I would do is put my headphones on so I can't hear.
Me too.
And I'm going to shoot this thing over here with the Vortex gun. I'm not convinced it will work. Yes. I'm also going to put my visor back on for this one. Except that I've left it over here. It's a bit difficult to get all of the pieces of equipment on at the same time. And you can't hear or see or really do anything, but hey. So what I'll do is light. Oh, look at that, it's all melted. That's probably not a good thing. So, turn this off so it doesn't make an accident. You probably ought to move.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll see if this works. It probably won't. Oh. Well, that was not very exciting. So we'll leave this, and it will get more exciting, because at some point that will go off, but there's nothing we can do about it at this point.
So, another failure?
Oh, another
failure. Why
are
you
looking
at me?
Because you're the most humorously scared.
Oh.
So, now it's been building now.
No more lectures.
Alright. Oh. How much pressure do you want in this?
Well, not a lot.
This should go bang.
This is, there was a problem with that one. Most of it came towards me, which I didn't think was a very good thing. So I put some methane in this one, and the methane should go up, which is better than down towards me. It's more likely to look a little bit like a mushroom cloud on fire, of course.
Anybody know how these things work?
It's not a bad thing.
I think you have to pull the ring and then throw it away. And then just put the other one.
Speak normally, isn't it? Put it over your nose and look at mouth and speak normally. Breathe normally. What do I do with the fire now?
That
put it
on the headphone, so I would do that as well.
Oh no, I wanted to just surprise you. Now. Oh, look at that. Two flames.
Two flames are more fun than one.
And I'm missing another piece of safety equipment. Let's put that on. They don't all work. You've got like a pile of safety equipment. This is not working very well.
Would you like to hold the fire extinguisher?
That's better.
He says that's better.
This should go up. Let me do the top.
Don't step on the explosives!
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. This is my princess pencil case. It says, wishes can come true. Which is alright if your wish is that this explodes.
Yeah, but wait, this is the reason why the other thing doesn't work, because this is not Princess Lilyfee, this is Kit Kat, Kitty Cat, right?
Oh.
Oh. So, the one thing that I forgot is, would have been important at this point. I'm going to wear my face mask, which I keep putting down. It's because I've got bad breath, and inside the shield, you get it all back in your face.
Especially if you don't clean it for 2 years.
So that's not any good, unfortunately, just yet. We'll come to that in a moment.
Instead, we're going to hang the monkey.
So, I just take some fuel. This is
fuel. Okay, here we go. Now we all heard that word, right? Fuel. We heard propane earlier. We heat methane. Now what do we got for fuel?
Fuel. This rocket is ether.
Ether.
Nice. And I'll hide this over here. No, it's a bad place. It's fine. I'll hide this over here. Next to some other line.
Okay. The monkey. He's
the monkey in here.
Goodbye, monkey. That stuff stinks. Okay. The monkey is not going to enjoy this.
So, I need this.
Okay, guys. There comes the monkey.
So, now I'm going to point it at you. Because that's a good idea.
Fly him to the moon. He's going to set fire to the hole.
Because I ran out of it, it was a bit too boring with methane in it. So I filled it up with hydrogen. I'm going to put these ear protectors on. You should put your ear protectors on. People near the front should probably close their ears. It is quite loud. We'll turn around so it goes that way. What will happen? So that we all know, Mr. Truck here will tear this piece of tape off and put his finger on. Then he'll tear this other piece of tape off and not put his finger on that one. And then I will light the hydrogen coming out of here. And then we will run away like the screaming cowards that we are. At some point, about 11 minutes later, Enough air will have gone into the bottom for it to have mixed up to make an explosive mixture, and then it will go pop, and the can will decide to leave at a high rate of speed, probably not hitting that line.
That would be exciting.
We need something a little bit more exciting to do that. But I am going to wear my ear protectors in case it's mixed. So there are two things. At the start, cover your ears in case it goes off immediately, because it has been known to do that. And afterwards, when the flame goes down, then it's getting kind of nervous. That's a good time to stop listening. So I'm going to put these on. Maybe this as well, in case it decides to come my direction.
Yeah. Okay, so everyone's set? Everyone's was ready? Good. I'm taking off the top piece of tape.
It's from NASA.
I'm taking off the top piece of tape now.
Put the earphone back on.
Finger on.
Yeah.
Okay, so you take away.
So, fingers on.
I'll take the bottom piece off.
And here we go.
Okay, so that's burning. It's burning quite a lot, so it's probably safe at the moment. And in the next, half an hour or so, something will happen. I'll set up the next thing in that time. It usually scares the crap out of me, though, when it goes out.
You'll not also be standing next to some explosives on the floor.
That might also go off at the same time, I think, last time. No, we can't do it again, but we can do a bigger one. You get to hold the stick again.
Okay.
And I'll set fire to this one. This one should be equally loud. Possibly a bit louder.
I think you can take the stick over towards the explosion.
Is he crying over there?
He's worrying.
Should I tell him to break
it? Does he need a toilet break?
I don't know. You put it down. No. You can't follow instructions. Do not ever ask your students to install these buttons.
I'm a theorist. Oh. This is the first time ever that I took
possibly going to be loud. I'm also a bit nervous about this one. You probably ought to go to your ears this time. I'll do the top. About doing this, and you won't see the vortex that comes out at the end because it will be moving at the speed of sound, so you can't see, which would be a bit rubbish. So let's leave that one to save a bit of time, because it's not as loud as the other one anyway. Aww. Let's do something that's a bit more exciting.
More exciting.
So what this is supposed to demonstrate is. Oh, you will do. So, let me get the other one. Let's do three of these. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the chemical called carbon disulfide, which is an interesting chemical because it smells just like farts. Could you turn that up and down, please?
Turn up one, up and down.
So just take it out and give it a bit of a slow. So there's one down here as well. Let me put this over here so it doesn't make the bad smell over here instead of over there. And the same thing with this one. That has more in it. We'll see if putting more in it is a good thing or a bad thing. You get the bad one. Oh!
Whoa! What have you done?
That was a bad thing.
Yeah, I'm supposed to let that out.
Very bad thing.
Oh, it smells like somebody blew off here.
Yeah, this is easy. easier said than done.
I'm just going to keep the top on.
Fine, so, this is easier said than done because he's never played rugby. I like it.
Should I put it off?
Yep. Take the top off.
Want to get the finger away?
Whoa!
Yep. Look at that.
It smells quite funky. That one was a little bit less motivated. See if anyone with lots of fuel is better or not. I think it's going to be worse.
I'm going to win though.
Happening there is the reaction is going nearly at the speed of sound in that gas, which is nitrous oxide. And if it passes the speed of sound, then it would probably explode, which that hydrogen oxygen did. And we would like that to happen, no we wouldn't. We would like that to happen maybe in a solid, because the speed of sound in solid is a bit higher, and that makes it more interesting. Hang on, I forgot what I was going to say now. It will appear very much. Got too many wires. No, I couldn't persuade any electronics engineers to make me the equipment. I would have done, but I wasn't allowed to.
The founder of the gear into the game.
Yeah, okay. So you don't want to use the joint.
This is already tricky. I don't want to inhale it.
He's just dumped the whole thing on a piece of paper.
But I want to be like Bill Clinton, I don't want to inhale it.
No inhale. Okay. We're just going to pour this in here. And then we've got a ramrod somewhere. Where's that chunk of aluminum we had earlier for ramming that home?
So, this one is comparatively safe.
I'm not sure that is actually an improvement on real gunpowder.
No, it's not.
Oh, there's bright red lights on the egg.
Bright red means it's ready to go. So I'm going to press. Is that it?
I mean, the blue screen actually helps. So you see, this was planned, right? Can we do another one? This was so nice.
Six. All right. 13 and six. You're up.
All right.
Don't get under the wires. 13. Let's see. 1, 3, 7, 4, 2, 12, 9, 8, 13. That'll do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I see somebody right there. I was like, yeah, there you are. And you can, yeah, one of you, doesn't matter which, one of you claims 6. There we go, there's the man.
Oh, no,
okay. All right. And I didn't tell you that you probably didn't ask me more, right?
Right.
Okay, so what I would like to do is bring our victim, that volunteer, this way. Mind the explosion. Mind the other explosions. I speak to my colleague over here, who will instruct you in a relatively straightforward bit of explanation of physics. We're going to see whether this man understands.
I need a joke here, guys.
All right. So, a really simple physics problem. Cue the physics problem. While I'm getting drinks. You need to come up with a simple physics problem this man has a chance of actually being able to.
Yeah.
Thematically associated to mushrooms.
Consider you have a uniformly changing magnetic field, right? So an AC current that produces a magnetic field. And you have an arbitrary mesh rule, right? Let's say a shopping mall. Is that the word? Well, I don't care what. Just a little eatable mushroom. And you let it fall within that oscillating field. So what will be the speed of the dropout?
At which speed will the mushroom fall,
yeah.
Given that the mushroom, now this might be a charged mushroom.
Microphone.
So, I'm just giving him some hints. You shut up out there.
All right, so now, think this through carefully.
Yes.
We've had the expert physicist over here. We're going to ask him also to solve the equation. He doesn't know that yet. So we won't tell him. Okay.
Of course
I can. So, we have to define this object that's falling. It's a mushroom. We need to decide what kind of mushroom. Because it's with the information about what kind of mushroom that we're going to be able to decide whether or not he's full of shit.
You killed it.
I killed it.
We were just trying to carry on.
Did
what? Okay.
This is a little bit more exciting than
normal black powder because it's got a metal in it instead, which is aluminium. It is also quite bright, so you should probably do this, which makes you all look really stupid while I'll be taking a picture. What I'll do is put my sunglasses on. Because that's cooler. What should happen is it should be slightly more dynamic than the last one. So let us see. It might be a bit loud as well. Oh, come on. No, okay, it didn't do it.
But we're going to get away from it.
But it did make a muffin. It exploded in the
chest. I love that it's gone.
And maybe it could have happened. But that was boring. So we'll have to go to something more exciting. What's in here is real explosive this time, because that was too boring last time. So I put some gun cotton in here. I haven't closed the top, because that would be illegal. So I've left it open. What is supposed to happen this time is that all of the flames and stuff go upwards, which will theoretically make a mushroom cloud. I didn't try this beforehand, because it takes quite a long time to make gun cotton. So I didn't have enough to do a practice run. So I'm hoping that this isn't too dangerous. Are you ready? I'm not. I'm not ready. It was enough. Who's in here next tomorrow? At least you'll know what it is. That was a better one. I don't Let me set the other garbage can off for the end.
That sounds like a good plan.
This is going to be crap-saculant.
Making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing the sleighing song tonight.